गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन, दिस इज लेक्चर नंबर 3 ऑफ चैप्टर नंबर 9 फूड प्रोडक्शन. चिल्ड्रन, एज मस्ट बी यू आर गेटिंग द फोन कॉल्स ऑफ योर क्लास टीचर्स एंड दे आर टेलिंग यू दैट यू हैव द एग्जाम्स मे बी इन द एंड ऑफ जुलाई और मे बी इन द फर्स्ट वीक ऑफ ऑगस्ट. सो द चैप्टर वी आर ऑलरेडी डीलिंग दैट चैप्टर नंबर 9. And before that, we were dealing with the chapter. We have already done chapter number 4 and 2. So 2, 4, 9 and 1 also we have done. But first chapter we have done in the month of April. So after 10 June, we have done chapter number 2, 4 and 9. So these three chapters are included for your first term. So please be ready with these chapters. So in this chapter, the chapter is not completed till now, but we will complete it before the exams. The chapter is food production. In that food production, we had discussed, in the first lecture, we had discussed about the microorganisms. Then after that, we had discussed about bacteria. Okay, the uses of bacteria in the food industries we had discussed. After that, we had discussed about fungi. Then some of the common examples of fungi we had discussed, that is mushroom we had discussed, yeast we have discussed, and after that we had discussed the economic importance of yeast. Economic importance of yeast that already we had discussed. So now today in this lecture number 3, we are going to discuss about agriculture. So, what is agriculture? First, the question arises here. What is agriculture? Agriculture means when we cultivate crops. Okay, definition is already given in your book. Agriculture is defined as a science of growing plants and other crops as well as rearing of animal for food and for other human needs. Okay, agriculture means in which we grow plants and crops. Secondly, we do rearing of animals for food and for any many other purposes. Okay, so why they have given that topic? Agriculture, primary food source. Primary means first. Okay, as we primary means without the agriculture, without the plants, we are not able to survive. We need plants. Then only the herbivorous animals are able to survive. If herbivorous, they are getting their food, they are eaten by the carnivorous, then the carnivorous are able to survive. So this is the primary source. The food is the primary source. Without the food, the human beings are not able to survive. We can live without having many number of clothes. We can live without having many number of gadgets. But we can't live without food. We can't live without water. So food is the primary need. Okay. So now today we are going to discuss about that which type of crops are present, which type of crops we grow. So the agriculture definition you have to learn it from here. Agriculture is defined as the science of growing plants and other crops as well as the rearing of animals for food and other human needs. Now, the crops means when we grow the plant. Okay, suppose at your home, you have some small pots. You are growing some fruits, some vegetables in that. Suppose nowadays, this is a season when the persons grow rice. So, when they are growing rice, so what is rice? Rice is the seed of that crop that we are going to use as a food. So, many plants we grow. Okay, when we are growing many plants, so from many plants we eat the seed of that plant, maybe we eat the root of that plant, maybe the fruit of that plant. So some of the part of the plant, it will be used as a food. So what are the crop plant? Crop plant means the same kind of plant. Okay, if you are growing a plant in your pot, so that is a single plant. Maybe in 2-3 pots you will grow 2-3 plants. So that is not a crop. Crop means when we are using a field to grow such plants. So what is crop? Crops are the plants of same kind which are grown on a larger scale in a field for food and for other useful purposes. Okay, now suppose if we want to grow rice, we are growing nowadays, if we can see in Jharkhand also, near to our areas also, the people, they are busy in that rice crop. So if we want to grow that crop in the month of December, we are not able to grow. Why? Because that is a seasonal crop. It is harvested on a particular time and it is sown in the field on a particular time. And throughout the year, during the rainy season, after the collection of water in the field, it can be grown. So when we are growing it on a large scale. So such type of crops are called crops. Okay, such type of plants are called crops. So edible means which can be eaten. So edible parts obtained from them may be in the form of grain. Grain means just like a rice. Many numbers of rice are there. Wheat, many number of wheats are there. Means small parts, if they are available, that is called grain. Roots, vegetables, fruits, any part. So the crop mainly that are grown in India, they are the cereal crops which we grow in India. This chart is only regarding the India. Pulses we grow, oil, some crops which gives us oil, just like groundnut, mustard, sunflower. These are the crops which we grow to get oil. Roots, sweet potato, we call it shakarkandi in Hindi. Turnip, carrot, radish, these all are the roots that we grow. Tuber crops, tuber means they are present below the soil and their same part, it can be used again and again for the growth. Just like potato, tropical. Next is sugar crops like sugar cane, beetroot. Plantation crop means these crops, they can be grown just to get only this particular part from them. Fiber, we can make the thread from them like cotton and jute. So all these crops are the crops of India. So these are the crops. So today we had discussed, now we are discussing, we have already discussed agriculture. What is agriculture? What is crop? Now, the crops, as we are discussing about crop, plants. So, crop, plants, they are of two type. Okay. Two type means, you can see in your book that they are of two type. They can be cultivated in two categories. One is the food crops. Food means the crop which provides us food are called food crop. Crops cultivated for the production of food are called food crops. Cash crops. Cash crops, they are used for commercial purpose. Okay, just like rubber, we don't eat rubber. This is we send to the factories. It is used for making different type of products. Tea also. When we send the tea, it will be transported to different countries. Coffee, spices, etc. So these crop, many spices we grow, all the spices we are not able to use at particular time, in particular period of time, within 1 year, 2 years. So these, when we grow them, they are transported to other countries also. So these type of crops we are using for commercial purposes. So the crop that we grow for the commercial purposes are called cash crops. The crops that are used for the production of food, those crops are called food crops. Okay, now the first is the food, the crops that we grow, food crops, in which season we grow. So that topic must be, you have studied in your previous classes. The crops, they can be divided into two types. One is the kharif crops, second is the rabi crops. So rabi crops are also called as winter crops, means grown in winter. Kharif crops are also called as autumn crops, means grown in autumn season. Just like June to October. Okay, so June to October, which type of crops we are growing nowadays? June to October means that period when it is a autumn season, maximum time it's rain. So you can see in the picture also, rice is the most important kharif crop of India, and it is grown in rain-fed areas. Rain-fed areas means which area? Just like Ranchi, just like Jharkhand. Jharkhand is also very famous for growing rice. So that is a kharif crop because it needs a lot of water for the growth, as well as it requires a hot and humid climate. We also feel sometimes it happens if it is not rain, it is not raining for 2 to 3 days. At that time, the atmosphere becomes hot, atmosphere becomes humid. After 2 or 3 days, when the rain comes, after that the atmosphere becomes normal. So the kharif crops, they are grown in the month of June to October. Rice is the important crop. They need rain, they need hot and humid climate. Okay, in other eastern and southern parts of the India, rice requires temperature of at least 16 degree to 20 degree Celsius. And when it is going to ripe, it requires the temperature of 18 to 32 degree. As well as the rainfall should be 150 to 200 centimeters. So that much amount of rainfall is required by kharif crop, that much temperature is required for their time of sowing as well as for the time of ripening. So now you can make the points in your own language. Kharif crops are grown in the month of June to October. They require hot and humid climate. They need at least the temperature when we are growing them, at that time they need the temperature of 16 to 20. And at the time of ripening, the temperature should be 18 to 32 degrees Celsius. Kharif crops require at least 150 to 200 centimeters of rainfall, or the field should be flooded with water during that period of kharif crops. Okay. Now the second type of crop is the rabi crops. Rabi crops means the crops that are grown in winter. So wheat is the most important rabi crop. Which type of soil it require? It require alluvial soil. It is mainly sown in the month of October or nearly November. They require the temperature when we are sowing the seed in this field, they require 10 to 15 degree temperature. And when we are cutting that crop after ripening, it requires 21 to 26 degree temperature. So annual average rainfall, they need almost 50 to 100. In case of kharif, they need 150 to 200. But in that case, they almost need 50 to 100 centimeter rain. So this is all about rabi and kharif crops. Please try to make the differences between rabi and kharif crops in your own words. You have your books, and the points are already in this topic. Please read it carefully, listen the video carefully and make the notes. Okay, now the next is topic is about the horticulture. That is also topic, horticulture. It is, what is horticulture? First understand that. When it is also a part of agriculture, when we grow fruits, vegetables, flower, mushrooms, algae and other medicinal plant, okay, including non-food means ornamental plants, trees, grasses, okay. Ornamental means we don't use them for eating, we just use them for decoration. That is called ornamental. So horticulture is the branch of agriculture which deals with the cultivation of fruits, vegetables, flowers, mushroom, medicinal plant as well as the non-food crops such as ornamental plant, trees, grasses, etc. So this type of branch of science is called horticulture. Okay, in horticulture, maximum which type of crop vegetables we grow? We grow cabbage, cauliflower, spinach, potato, onion, etc. Many are there. Ornamental plants means we grow crotons, collis, fern, bougainvillea. So what are these, children? These are simply the ornamental plants. Crotons means they give different type of colors. So these are just, you can say these are the flowers also, leaves also. We use them not for eating, we just use them for decoration. Bougainvillea, I think you all have seen. Now, the people, they grow those plants near to their hedges, near to their boundaries, just for decoration. Ferns also, they grow near to their houses. Just go to the YouTube, just type that word, you will find the pictures of these type of plants. Other than that, in horticulture, we grow flowers. Flowers like rose, gelodius, and chrysanthemum, jasmine. So, rose, sunflower, chrysanthemum, they have shown you in the picture. Others, just you find and just see the pictures of those flowers. So, such type of plants we use, we grow in horticulture. So, that these are the non-green. So, that is why. But still, we are using them, we are cultivating them, so that branch is called horticulture. Next is the, nowadays it is very famous, that is the organic farming. Okay, nowadays what the farmer do, because as we know in the fields the people use pesticides, they use fungicides, and those fungicides and pesticides, we when wash the vegetables, wash the fruits, they are, most of them, they are removed from those parts, but sometimes they are still stick with that vegetables or fruits, and when we eat them, they goes inside our body, so that will be very harmful for our body. So instead of using those harmful chemical fertilizers, pesticides, weedicides, etc., what the farmer do nowadays, they are using organic manure. The farmers use organic manure. And how they make that organic manure? They make the organic manure with the help of organic waste of crops, animals, farm waste, aquatic waste, other biological material. Okay, so the things that can be decayed by microorganisms, they use such type of things, and they don't use the weedicide, they don't use the pesticide, and through this they grow the plant. So what is organic farming? It is a practice of raising crops without using synthetic fertilizers and pesticides. Okay, without using synthetic fertilizers and pesticides. So that branch of science in which we use, we don't use the synthetic fertilizer and pesticide, and we grow the crops, that is called organic farming. Okay, so why we do organic farming? The aim of organic farming is to enhance soil fertility. Why we do organic farming? Just to increase the soil fertility as well as to create a eco-friendly environment. Okay, that environment that should be free from chemical pollution. So the crop that we grow by doing the organic farming, those crops are very nutritive, means they contain a lot of nutrients in large amount. So that is why nowadays organic farming is one of the most important, or you can say must, one of the most useful farming, because when we eat the products obtained by organic farming, we don't face any trouble related to our body. And those products, the organic farming crops, they give us proper nutrients. We can say they give us high nutritional value. And as well as they increase the soil fertility, they make the environment eco-friendly. So these are the uses. We can ask you, what is the aim of organic farming? So you can give that they, to increase the soil fertility, to make the environment eco-friendly. So children, please write the definition of organic farming, horticulture, write the differences between kharif and rabi crop, write what is food crop, what is cash crop, what is agriculture, and what do you mean by crop. Already all the things are in your book. So please read the chapter carefully and write the answers. Okay, thank you children.